a advice session.
Those innocent eyes.
Hey Tokas, it's Toby. Welcome to welcome back to my channel. Before you get started, you should check out all my socials linked below. Anyways, so I've asked you guys to give me some things that you want advice on because I love giving advice and I feel like giving an advice session would be really cool. A lot of these were DMs and messages, and yeah, let's just get started. The first thing I'm going to be giving advice on is how to deal with fake friends. I think at least once in your life, you're gonna have maybe one or several fake friends. This may happen more than once in your life, FYI. But I think the first thing that's important is realizing they are fake friends. Fake friends could be friends that, you know, one second they need you for homework and they're your best friend, but then when you don't give them the answers, they're not your friend. You know what I mean? Toxic friends are those friends that make you feel self-conscious about something and honestly just always make you feel mentally like drained after hanging out with them. From my experience, a lot of the time those toxic friends make you feel like it's a chore to be your friend and that you're terrible, and honestly you are not. You're amazing and you deserve loving friends, and I think that accepting that they're toxic and accepting that you deserve better friends is the first thing to do. Now, depending on the situation, you may be more of an awkward person, which is fine. I'm more of an awkward person. And maybe you decide that you're going to text them a really sweet paragraph, basically complimenting them, making them feel good about themselves, but saying that maybe depending on your situation, you may be able to tell them that this is just an unhealthy environment for you, or by telling them that you just think that they should worry more on themselves than you. And saying things like that always makes them feel good. And I think it's really important that to get rid of the toxic friends, because quite literally they can ruin your life. And I love you all so much, and I don't want that to happen. The next tip is telling your mother that you don't feel comfortable doing something. I got one of these, questions before, and honestly, this is kind of complicated and kind of hard to answer. I'm not talking about you don't want to do a chore or something like that. I'm talking about maybe she wants you to do a sport or a club, and you don't want to disappoint her. However, it is something that you know is not for you, and you're going to be miserable doing it. So you can either write a paragraph, talk to her in person, or something, but basically sit her down, let her read a note, let her see a text, tell her in person that this is something that you don't think would be good for you. Basically, just tell her that you want to always impress her and that you love her. However, this is not something that is going to be nice for you, and you don't think that this is a crowd that you're going to fit in with, or this is something that isn't like you, and that, you know, as your mom, or, you know, as, you know, being my mom, I think that you would understand that this is not something that I'm interested in, and I wanted to be honest with you. Mothers love maturity. Any parent, any guardian, whatever, who loves with you, who takes care of you, who makes the decisions, and most of the time, if you're just honest like that, you will get a lot further than if you just scream out or act out. The next one is to tell your trio, which if you don't know, that's a group of three friends, that you feel left out. This one, I think, is so incredibly important. I think that it's important to make sure that you're close to both friends and making sure that you're putting in effort to be friends with both of the people. And then after that, I know it's hard because I was in a trio. They can end really well, but for me, it didn't end well. So I would say definitely speak to one of them. And just tell them, like, hey, I'm feeling left out. See if anything changes. Then you turn around and you go to the other person and you tell them you feel left out. But I would, you know, either text them, tell them in person, write a note, whatever you feel is going to work best for your specific situation. And just tell them that you feel like maybe it's not a mutual decision. Maybe we just not cut out to be friends. Like, you know, just be honest and say how you feel and that you're not mad at them or anything. And that you're not trying to argue. And honestly, all I can do is hope for the best. Sometimes friends are not meant to be, but I have faith in you guys. The next thing is how to make new friends, because this is something that is really difficult for a lot of people. So if you're struggling to make friends, no matter what situation, you are not alone. It is very common. I won't lie, I'm not very social, so I don't have the greatest advice on this one. But the best thing that you can do is be yourself and walk directly up to the group of people that you want to be friends with. Basically ask, hey, I'm your name. So I'd be like, hey, I'm Chloe. would you mind if we hung out, or can I hang out with you guys? And then, or you can even say, do you want to be friends directly, or can I have your Snapchat? Anything like that. Honestly, the thing is, you have to get the fact that they're going to judge you out of your head, because you don't know them, you don't know what they're going to say, and you just got to live in the moment and hope for the best. I'm sure that any singular person in the world would want to be your friend, because you're amazing. The very last thing I'm going to be giving you advice on is how to tell your parents you did something really bad. Now, I'm not talking, oh my god, I forgot to wash the dishes. I'm talking something that you know they're going to be super, super, super upset, more than average. So for normal, you probably can just straight up tell them, and you know, obviously you're going to be a little scared, but it won't be that end of the deal. I think the best thing you can do is evaluate your situation first and decide what you did. Understand what you did, accept that it's wrong, and my favorite thing to do is I don't text them, because if they're going to take my phone, I just feel weird about texting on my phone. So I make a note. So I sit down, I write on a piece of paper what I did wrong. That's first. Then I write down that I know that it was wrong and that I shouldn't have done it. Then I list things that are a possible solution to the problem. After that, I write that I am sorry again, and then I basically give them ideas that they can do to teach me to know better, and I give it to them, let them read it, I walk away, they come and call me back, and we discuss it, and it has always gone better for me if I have openly just told them, so please just openly tell them, don't let them find out on their own, and honestly, you know, accept that you may have to face some time. However, you did a mature way. Like, I know if I did something wrong, I cannot say it without, like, bawling my eyes out. So, writing notes is more my method. And also, you don't say something stupid, you know? Okay, we are 7 minutes in, so I'm gonna end the video here. Because if I make this video any longer, my storage will not be able to handle it. But anyway, shout goes the person on the screen. I love your profile picture. It is adorable. Comment more things that you want advice on in the comments, because I do want to make this kind of like a series. I love you guys so much. You guys are beyond amazing. I'll see you in the next video. Bye, Tokas.